Hi, my name is Aaron Clark. I'm a mechanical engineer and one of the co-developers of MedCline. In this video, we're going to be discussing your stomach anatomy and how it affects reflux. We have here a model of the stomach. Your stomach has an exit valve here called the pyloric sphincter, and this tube here represents your esophagus, or the tube that brings food from your mouth down into your stomach. Now, right before this tube connects with your stomach is something called the lower esophageal sphincter. This is a circular band of muscles that opens up to let food through into your stomach and is supposed to close to keep the food from going back out into your esophagus. To show how this works, we're going to fill the stomach with some fluid. Okay, so I have my stomach here full of fluid. Now, you're wondering, what causes heartburn at night? Well, when you're upright during the day, your stomach contents, if it comes up and goes into your esophagus, it can come right back down because gravity works pretty well for bringing it back down to the stomach. At night, however, this represents you sleeping on your back. As you can see, the valve, if it's operating improperly, it'll open up to allow this reflux to come back into your esophagus. So, what can you do about this? Well, some people try to sleep on a bed wedge or elevating the head of their bed. Now, if you're elevating the head of your bed, you're at a little bit of an angle, which can kind of help a little bit. If you're on a bed wedge, you can be a little bit more angle, but the problem is you end up sliding down to where just your head and shoulders are elevated, which your upper body and your stomach ends up being flat, which is nothing for your reflux. So what else can you do? Well, doctors often recommend sleep on your left side as opposed to your right. Why is that? Well, if you're on your right side, this represents your stomach on the right side, this valve, the lower esophageal sphincter, can actually become submerged in your stomach acid and stomach contents. So if that valve were to open up here, this liquid contents flows right into your esophagus, causing heartburn, regurgitation, some really distressing symptoms. So instead, doctors have you sleep on your left side. This is because when you're on your left side, the lower esophageal sphincter can actually be below this air fluid level, or the fluid of the level of the stomach contents in your stomach. So you might wonder, well then how can, if my stomach contents is down here, how could it get into my esophagus? Because you probably tried to sleep on your left side. Well, when your stomach squeezes to squeeze the food out the pyloric sphincter, this, as your stomach squeezes, actually push the food back the other direction if you have a poor functioning lower esophageal sphincter. If your incline's not working, your left side's not working all that well, what can you do? That's where MedCline comes into play. MedCline provides superior inclining compared to a wedge or putting blocks in the head of your bed, but also allows you to sleep on your left side. So let me show you. On MedCline, not only are you left side, so you get this benefit of pulling that fluid away, but as you do the incline, it pulls this air fluid level even further away from your lower esophageal sphincter. What does that do for you? Well, as your stomach squeezes to squeeze the food out, if any food does happen to go up into your esophagus, gravity will pull it right back down. So you're getting the benefits of fewer reflux episodes on your left side, and if any episode happens to occur, it goes away much faster because of the incline. So that's a little bit about how MedCline works. If you have any other questions, please give us a call at 1-800-610-1607 or shoot us an email at support@medcline.com.